Good morning. Welcome to St. Michael the Archangel Catholic Church. If you have not already done so, please take this opportunity to silence your cell phone. Today we are celebrating the 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and our presider is Father Mike Guarino. At this time, I invite you to please stand and join in singing our opening song, The Summons, which is found on your worship aid.
Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me? Will you leave yourself behind if I but call your name? Will you care for cruel and kind and never be the same? Will you risk the hostile stare? Should your life attract or scare? Will you let me answer prayer in you and you in me?
Good morning. We offer our Mass together this morning for Jenny Hart and Noah Bryan for a happy first birthday. And let us begin as we begin all our prayer, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to worthily celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, that we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. I prayed, and prudence was given me. I pleaded, and the spirit of wisdom came to me. I preferred her to scepter and throne, and deemed riches nothing in comparison with her. nor did I liken any priceless gem to her, because all gold in view of her is a little sand, and before her, silver is to be accounted mire. Beyond health and comeliness, I loved her, and I chose to have her rather than the light, because the splendor of her never yields to sleep. Yet all good things together came to me in her company, and countless riches at her hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Just to number our days aright, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants. Fill us with your love, O Lord, and we will sing for joy. Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days. Make us glad for the days when you afflicted us, for the years where we saw evil. Fill us with your love, O Lord, and we will sing for joy. Let your work be seen by your servants, and your glory by their children. Let your work, and may the gracious care of our Lord, our God, be ours. Prosper the work of our hands for us. Prosper the work of our hands. Fill us with your love, O Lord, and we will sing for joy.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, indeed, the word of God is living and effective, sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating even between soul and spirit, joints and marrow, and able to discern reflections and thoughts of the heart. No creature is concealed from him, but everything is naked and exposed to the eyes of him to whom we must render an account. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. As Jesus was setting out on a journey, a man ran up, knelt down before him and asked, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" Jesus answered him, "Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. You shall not defraud. Honor your father and your mother." He replied and said to him, "Teacher, all of these I have observed from my youth." Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said to him, "You are lacking in one thing. Go, sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me." At that statement, his face fell, and he went away sad, for he had many possessions. Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, "How hard it is for those who have wealth to enter the kingdom of God." The disciples were amazed at his words. So Jesus again said to them in reply, "Children, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for one who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." They were exceedingly astonished and said among themselves, "Then who can be saved?" Jesus looked at them and said, "For human beings it is impossible, but not for God. All things are possible for God." Peter began to say to him, "We have given up everything and followed you." Jesus said, "Amen, I say to you, there is no one who has given up house or brothers or sisters or mother or father or children or lands who will not receive 100 times more now in this present age, houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands with persecutions, and enter life in the age to come." The Gospel of the Lord. I heard the story of a man who was an expert in diamonds, and he happened to be on a plane sitting next to a woman who had an enormous diamond on her finger. Finally, he introduced himself and he just said, "You know, I couldn't help but noticing that diamond. It's beautiful." He said, "You know, I'm an expert in precious stones. Tell me about that stone." So she said to him, "You know, this diamond is the famous Kloppman diamond." She said, "It's one of the largest in the world. But there's a strange curse that comes with it." Well, now he was really interested. And so he said, "Well, what's the curse?" And he waited with bated breath as she said, "Mr. Kloppman." Some of you might want to reassess your diamonds in terms of these, what we just said. But seriously, you know, the real curse of any kind of valuable possession is its capacity to steal our hearts and our souls. The rich young man that we read about is one of those characters, unique characters in Scripture, that has come to represent greed. So he just wouldn't give up his possessions, so unwilling to give up his possessions that he actually lost his soul because of his money. Oh, he wanted salvation, but not at the expense of giving up what he possessed. You know, I always find it interesting when I read this story about the fact of just how close he was to the kingdom of God. He had all the right answers. He believed in the law and he understood it. He understood the teachings of Jesus, but love for money just kept him away. In some ways, we've always looked upon him, I think, as a moral coward. But I think that that assessment is just too simple. I think there are many good things that can be said about that man. I don't know about you, but I was very impressed when I read this also. The fact that just after speaking with Jesus for a few minutes, Mark tells us that Jesus looked at him and loved him. That doesn't sound like a scathing criticism to me. I think what we have to remember too is this young man didn't see Jesus as the Son of God. He saw him as a new prophet with an exciting message, a magnetic personality, and eyes that gripped you when you spoke to him. Jesus was not the Christ to him of the Apostles' Creed. At that point in his ministry, even for his disciples, they didn't look upon him in that same regard. The Easter stone had not been rolled away. I think I could spend a little time and kind of talk about that young man and kind of hold him up maybe even for admiration. And then I could look at the things that were his fatal flaws. You know, positively, you know, those are the things that brought him to the Master. The qualities in him that made him seek the teachings of Jesus. Some of those positive qualities, first of all, he was courageous. And he was, to do what he did in this gospel. He was humble. You know, this very, very wealthy man, and some say he was even of royalty. He was humble to come and kneel before Jesus. And also, he was someone, it seemed, who was somewhat open. But then there are those negative things. Those negative things that made him turn away from Jesus. I think the first negative thing is that he came to Jesus and what he was looking for was a rule or a law that he could follow. He wasn't looking for a relationship. I think the second negative thing, of course, was his love, deep love for money. And the third negative thing was he walked away. I think after reading this gospel, I think it's probably incumbent for all of us to just find our place in all of it. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in God, for whom all things are possible, let us offer these petitions.
For a renewed commitment within the church to serving the poor, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the wisdom to always seek the kingdom of God and to share our blessings with those in need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the trust needed to answer Christ's call to come and follow me, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For eternal rest for all those who have died, especially Georgia Afanasieff, Lori Gadsden, and Joe Stein, who recently passed away, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Jenny Hart and Noah Bryan, whom we are remembering in a special way in this Eucharist, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of the parish prayer line, the intentions in the parish prayer boxes, and for our own special intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Glorious God, we offer these prayers to you through the intercession of your Son, Jesus Christ, our ever-present companion, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the Eucharistic offerings of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body, by his body and blood, and filled with his Holy Spirit, we may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Frank, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, and there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Offer each other safely a sign of God's peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. pre-announcements for today. Monday, October 11th, the parish office will be closed in observance of Columbus Day, that's tomorrow. Regular office hours will resume on Tuesday. Next Saturday, October 16th, there will be a funeral mass and burial for James Stanton at 10 a.m. There will also be a funeral service for Barbara Humphrey at 12:30 p.m. All Arimatheans are invited to attend the masses to support the families. And also, Father Michael will be on his annual retreat this week, and he will not be available at the office. Let us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord and one another. A senior couple was driving cross country, and at this time the wife was driving and she got stopped by the police, and the policeman comes up to the window and says, "Ma'am, do you realize you were speeding?" And she was very hard of hearing, and she looked at her husband, "What did he say?" And he yelled back, "He said you were speeding, so then I need to see your license." "What did he say?" "He wants to see your license." So he takes the license and he looks at it and he sees it there from Arkansas. And he said, "You know, I used to live in Arkansas for quite a while. And I always remember I went out on a blind date with the most obnoxious, ugly woman I've ever met in my life." "What did he say?" "He said he thinks he knows you."
Joyful, joyful, we adore you, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold like flowers before you, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubt away. Giver of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of day. All your works with joy surround you, earth and heaven reflect your rays. Stars and angels sing around you, center of unbroken praise. Field and forest, vale and mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and flowing fountain, sound their praise to eternity.
Game today.
Oh, I know. I'd love that. 1-1 They killed them the other day, but then they're five. Well,